Welcome back. In this video, we're going to discover how we can attach something to the link, but this time dynamically. So if I click on this link, we now have our affiliate ID attached here, which we have done in the last video. But what if I wanted to change this affiliate ID around based on where the user came from? Well, you might know that in our Amazon affiliate account, you can place different tracking codes. I just have two right here, one for AdWords and one for Facebook and one generic one. Now, I would like to know how many people are coming through the AdWords channel onto my page, and then I forward it onto Amazon and then actually buy. Now, I obviously need to somehow dynamically change the links around if this user was an AdWords user, a Facebook user, or something else based on where the user came from. And we'll be able to utilize a technique that I have showed off in a while ago, really long time ago, which is the source cookie alternative that I have presented here, which writes your sources into a cookie. So let's go over back to our page. I already have this deployed here. So at the heart of this is a tag that sets the source cookie, and this only on the landing pages, depending on where the user came from. In our case, I can look up this cookie inside of our developer tools under application. I have here the cookies from our website, and we see a source cookie, which lists all the different sources that the user came from, given that they have been UTM tagged. So in our case, if I would come from a UTM source, so let's just make this up. I come from, now let's say, so we come from our email newsletter. These are UTM tagged. We should be able to write this then into our cookie. And we see right here, it was extended to include our newsletter as well. Now, if the user comes back to something else, for example, an AdWords click, which usually has the GCL ID automatic attached, then this should be also written into our source cookie. Let's see. Oops. Here we see we have Google Ads now attached to our source cookie. Now, every time somebody enters through Google Ads, I want to now attach to my Amazon link a different affiliate ID instead of this affiliate ID. I want to attach, let's go over here, the AdWords 20 ID. So it's really just the difference of this right here. Now then, Amazon would report this in a different way, so I would be able to see how many clicks and how many buys went through this particular channel of mine. Now, since we have that information available where the user came from in the source cookie, we can read that source cookie. I've already built a variable for this right here. We have our source cookie, and then we can extract the last known source, which I've put into this last source variable, which I can now use to build my links up programmatically. One step in between, if Google Ads is shown, I want to rewrite this into my affiliate link. So let's go over to Google Tag Manager first of all and build a new lookup table variable, which will let us rewrite our affiliate links automatically. So we'll build a lookup variable for our Amazon IDs. In this case, we'll choose as a type the lookup table variable. And as the input, we'll simply use our last known source and add a row here. Well, we just need to actually. Now, if the last known source is Facebook, facebook.com, then I want to rewrite this into our Amazon link. Let's go back here. Want to attach this FB. And if it's Amazon, I want to attach a W, and this would be, in our case, let's go back. It needs to be exact, so we don't have margin for error here. Google Ads. And the default value, so if nothing is true, I simply want to turn this into our normal tag, which was this one. All right, now that we have this prepared, we can utilize this in our attach linker, which we have already looked at in the last lesson, and simply replace our attachment string here with our lookup table variable, which is two curly brackets. We just need to find it in this menu right here, and this should do it. Let's save this and try this out. See? So this has been deployed. And if I click on buy product, I now see that our AdWords was attached to this link, which I wanted because I just entered the page through AdWords. What if I came through Facebook? Well, this UTM source needs to be facebook.com actually. Let's press enter. And we just simulated that we came through Facebook. Let's buy a product. And we see now Facebook is attached. And let's do the same again with a UTM that is tagged from email. Press enter. And we see if I buy the product, it just gives me the normal URL affiliate tag at the end. So this works as expected and is highly valuable for those of you who want to track or get a better, deeper understanding of your traffic channels that are going out to Amazon. Because in the reporting itself, if you go over here to the reporting of the earnings, we should cut this out. We can now see reporting for all our tracking IDs or just who came through AdWords, who came through Facebook, and how much money we made with them. So hugely valuable when it comes to the tracking outside of our own website and passing that information on to something like Amazon. But really this technique could be used in other ways as well. So you'll be able to pass on information to your tracking systems, to your checkout pages that may live on a different platform, or cross-domain tracking in a sense that you would be able to pass on information about the sources or about the user ID to a different website. As long as the system accepts these values, you could then see them in their system as well. Wow, this was a lot of stuff in these little videos. I hope you enjoyed them. And if this triggered something in you and you thought, wow, I want to use this tracking technique for this special case, please let me know about the cases. I'm so interested in the cases that you would be using this tracking technique down below in the comments. We can all learn from the different tracking cases that you might come up with and maybe I didn't come up with in this tutorial. As always, if you enjoyed this video, then why not give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel right over there because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.